Hey everyone, thank you so much for being here today. My name is Denise. I'm also known as Hey Wig Sister on Instagram and Facebook. Today I'm here to bring you a wig review in partnership with Name Brand Wigs. This is Coco by Belle, Tress in the color Tress, Leches, Blonde. I had to do a couple of takes on that. I had trouble saying it. Tress, Leches, Blonde. I hope I said it right. It is a heat-friendly wig with a center mono part and a lace front and a really pretty blonde. If you want to know more about this style, stick around. Thank you, Name Brand Wigs, for sending me Coco so I could show all of my wig sisters another style that might work for them and talk a lot about the color, which I am falling in love with. I like the rooted blondes, and this is a rooted blonde. So if you've never been to Name Brand Wigs, I highly recommend you go to their website. It is www.namebrandwigs.com. I've been a customer of theirs since the very beginning of my wig wearing journey. And I started partnering with them on some reviews about a year ago, and I'm so grateful at the amount of education that they allow to be sent out to the wig wearing community. It's just so helpful to all of us to have all of this information. You can also email them, support@namebrandwigs.com. You can also call them. They have a phone number at their website. So if you're struggling at all with the wig wearing journey, if you're struggling to find the right style or color for you, or you're looking for something that's similar to something that you already have, they can totally help you. So please reach out to them. All right, let's take a look at Coco from all sides. Coco has some bouncy curls. It's like a kind of a shoulder length bob that you took a big barrel curling iron, maybe a 1.25 inch curling iron. You put some barrel curls in and then you brushed them out. That's what this reminds me of. It's very cute. It's kind of sassy. It's cute. I really love these curls. These are some of my favorite types of curls. They just look so natural. I really appreciate that. Now, we have got a center part line and a lace front. I know that some of you don't love the center part. What Belle Tress does is they make the lace front really wide up to about here. So that technically allows you to do more of an off-center part. If you don't mind a little bit of a messy part, you can do more of an off-center part in front, and then it will flow back into that part line. Another thing you could do if you don't love a center part is you could, if you like bangs, you could cut a bang in, and that will help a lot. Now, because of how this particular piece was constructed, there is a lot of lift in the front. If you are a bang wearer and you really want this style, this is heat friendly, so you can take heat to it and you can get that bang to lay a little bit flatter. That is one option for you. Now, this is, I would consider this a moderate density. It's not heavy density, it's not light density. It's really in between, kind of a really natural density. And there's a little bit of permatease right at the cap back here. Belle Tress doesn't really make wigs with heavy pillowy permatease. So what you have, I think it's technically permatease, but really it's just crimpy fibers that help to hide the cap. So if the hair blows around in the wind, the permatease helps with that. I know I have a lot of wig sisters who really can't stand permatease. You don't want any. It's so difficult for a wig to look natural and for you not to be able to see the wefting in cap without any permatease at all. Unless you go with a fully hand tied cap, that's your solution if you don't want permatease. But on a style like this, I think you do need a little. It's just got that type of a curl pattern without any crimpy fibers at all. It would really fall flat. So I think they did the exact right amount of crimpy fibers right in here to kind of give it a little bit of lift in the back. But there's nothing up here, so you maintain a flatness on top. If you need lift on top, This one doesn't have that. So you've got some lift and volume here from the curls, and then it's real flat on top. So just think about what looks best on you and your face shape to make your best decision. Now this does have the lace front, like I said, and we'll take a look at that lace front right here. Belle Tress has gotten a lot better at their lace fronts. They didn't start off excellent, especially in the darker colors, but what they've started to do is they've started to take the highlighted pieces, as you can see here, and bring them up to the front. That helps a lot to hide any dark knotting, and they've started to make their knots relatively small so that you really can't see them as well. So this is a really good lace front. It allows you to do off the face styling if you want to, and that is really helpful. Please keep in mind this little tidbit, and it's not just for Belle Tress wigs, it's for all wigs. There is variation in color from piece to piece, especially pieces that have highlights and a variety of colors. How those colors are placed, they do their very best to place them similarly, but they cannot place them identically, especially in a wig like this that has hand-tied features. This whole front is hand-tied. The parting space is hand-tied. You will notice there is a heavy highlight right here. That may not be as heavy on yours. It may be heavier. It's very hard to say. If you get a piece, and again, this is across the brands that do this, not just Belle Tress. If you get a piece and you don't like how heavy the highlights are in the front, it may be worth exchanging it for another one, and you might find that it will vary. Just keep that in mind. It is a part of the wig wearing journey that can be a challenge. It's kind of the nature of the beast, and I do like to share all of that with you so that you are very well informed. So here's that lace front. It's extended to almost all the way to the ear tabs. There's your center monofilament. You can see that wide parting space right there. Soft ear tabs with bendable stays, extended nape, bra strap adjusters. These aren't the best. That's my opinion. They don't like to stay cinched. So if you are someone where Belle Tress runs big on you and Belle Tress runs big on me, and you pull these and they don't stay, put a little stitch in there. It will hold it in place. The rest of this is open wefted so that you get that coolness from the open wefting. One more look at those really pretty curls. I really like these curls a lot. So let's talk about this, the fit of Belle Tress. They are known for running big. They're considered a big head friendly brand. I think that they run, you know, where some brands maybe run average petite, I think Belle Tress runs at average large. They tend to run big on me. I do have to cinch them in. I get a lot of extra cap on the top. They are very, very stretchy wigs, incredibly stretchy wigs. So there's a lot of stretch on Belle Tress. So if you have been struggling to find a wig that fits you because you have larger head measurements, I recommend that you check out Belle Tress and see if maybe that will help you. I have a feeling. It's hard when I put the wig on camera because it doesn't always fall into place perfectly. This one wasn't exactly shake and go. I had to play with it a little bit. I had to brush it. So I did comb out these curls a little bit because they were very, very formed and didn't really look all that natural. And I am struggling a little bit with this front part to get it to lay right. That may not be the case on your piece. That's another variation. Depending on how it was in the box, depending on the conditions that box lived in, if it went through a lot of extreme temperature changes, that can cause some, just a little bit of different, what's called cold setting, or the fibers act a little funny. Sometimes it just needs time out of the box. Sometimes you need to use a little heat on it. The beauty is this is heat friendly. You can take heat up to 325 degrees and you can straighten it. You can put more curl in it. You can relax. Maybe you don't want quite this much curl, but you want a little bit. You can relax the curl a little bit. So there is a lot you can do with a heat friendly piece. This one is also of a good length. So if you want to do some styling, you can do some half up, half down. You can do some off the face styling, and it definitely allows for all of that. So we'll move on to color. Now I always do show you the color outside, so we will get outside with this one. So let's talk about it inside first though. So this, the name Tres Leches actually means three milks. That's what it says on the website. I don't speak Spanish, or I think that's Spanish, but it means three milks. And this color is a reflection of a variety of sort of white blonde, caramel blonde, and light honey blonde. It is rooted with a blend of light, medium, and dark brown. It's actually a fairly light root. This color reminds me a lot of Raquel Welch shaded Biscuit. I think it has a little bit more warmth to it, just a little bit more of that caramel blonde than shaded Biscuit. Shaded Biscuit, I think, has just a little bit more of the platinum, but not much. I would say you would notice the differences if they're side by side, not as much if you just got this one and wore it. It's very dynamic, and guys, I really want to stress that's not a super dark root. It's really not. And it's very diffused. I think it's a product of them blending quite a few browns, and then some of the blonde diffuses up there, so it's very diffused, and it's not warm. So for my wig sisters who struggle with those dark roots, this is not a dark root. It's very, very natural. Makes it very wearable for a lot of women with a variety of natural bio hair. And then you can see it's definitely a very dynamic blend. You can see some of the very light platinum. You can see the caramel, the honey. Lots of variation in this color. I would consider it warm. I think some of that platinum mitigates any yellowness. In some light, it maybe pull a tiny bit yellow, but I really wouldn't consider this a super yellow blonde. Let me grab a shaded Biscuit so you can see it side by side. All right, here they are, side by side, shaded Biscuit, Tres Leches, blonde. You can kind of see there's more of the platinum in this one, but not a ton. And then the rooting on shaded Biscuit is darker. It's darker. Look at that. Less diffused. But you know what? It's also, well, it's not really that much shorter. So if you're a fan of shaded Biscuit, ask yourself, what do you like best about it? Is it the dark root? Is it more of the platinum? They're close, but not identical. All right, you guys, let's get outside so you can see this color outside. Thank you so much, Name Brand Wigs. This was fun to show. I hope it helped you guys a lot. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you in my next video. All right, friends, here we are with Tres Leches Blonde outside. Little wind so you can see how it blows. Get up close. Hopefully that was helping you guys. I don't know, maybe I was off frame on that one. All right, thanks for watching.
All right, everyone, here comes the unboxing of Coco. So this is the first time I've seen it, and I really actually didn't know what to expect. I didn't even look up this style before it came, so I had no preconceived notions of it. You'll be able to see exactly how it looked out of the box. And I mentioned I had combed it out, and you can see why. It definitely needed a little style enhancement. The curls were compacted and tightly formed, and that is very common. It was also a little bit challenging to figure out that front, as you can see here, but just a little bit of working with it, heat from my hands, worked just fine. Hope you enjoyed this unboxing. Thanks for watching.